Clairs, welcome to my channel, court.is.clair, and I am court.is.clair. If you're new to my channel, thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. And to all my old subbies out there, hey girl, hey, hey boy, hey, welcome back. Thank you so much for your support. You guys really make this such an enjoyable experience, and I appreciate y'all from the bottom of my heart. Well, as you know, if you see this scrub top, that means that this video is going to be nurse related. And today this video is about 5 rookie travel nurse mistakes that I have made. So if you are interested in being a travel nurse, maybe you are already a travel nurse, maybe you're exploring different specialties within nursing, or maybe you just plain old nosy, either way you slice it, please continue to watch. And most of all, don't forget to like and subscribe. Okay, so let's just get right into it. If you don't know me, I'm court.is.clair, and I have been a registered nurse for 10 years. 3 of those years I was travel nursing. So, I mean, I feel like I have a good wealth of knowledge when it comes to travel nursing. And actually, information was not readily available back then when I started as much as it is now, especially with the Facebook forums and those Facebook groups. And just, there's a lot of information about travel nursing. But I'm going to express to you guys my rookie travel nurse mistakes. And especially since I was getting some different comments about, like, do pros and cons of travel nursing, I'm actually thinking about doing a travel nurse series. So you guys just drop comments below and let me know if that will be beneficial to do a series and talk about travel nursing. But anyway, this is 5 rookie travel nurse mistakes, okay? First of all, know your why. I did not know my why going into travel nursing. I just wanted to do it. To be quite frankly honest, I wanted to be a travel nurse before I even knew what type of specialty I wanted. I had no clue of what, if I wanted to be L&D, if I wanted to be IC. I had no idea, but I did know that I was going to be a travel nurse. But that's not enough when you are on the road, when you're actually living the travel nurse life. It can be tedious. It can be, you know, lonely. It can be overwhelming because you have to continuously start over. So I would say to know your why. If you're getting into travel nursing for the experiences, know that. And when that way, when things get tough, you have that why to fall back on. If you're getting into travel nursing because you're in it to make the money, know that why as well. So that way, when times get tough, you can push through and say, you know what, y'all, I'm going to be getting my check. So I'm not going to listen to y'all today. I'm just going to come here, do what I have to do, give the best care possible to my patients, get my check, and go home. Okay, so know your why. That was a mistake that I came into the game with. I didn't really figure out my travel nurse why until about 2 years into it. And then that's when it really started to become really beneficial for me because I got really intentional. So number 2 travel nurse rookie mistake that I made was not having a budget. I'm gonna be real with y'all. I did not have a budget till I was about 30, 31 years old. I did not know that households should run off of budgets just to see what is coming in and what is coming out of the household financially. And I didn't learn that until, like I said, about 2 years into travel nursing. And that's, you should know your budget because that's going to let you know what is a good travel nurse contract for you. Because I see a lot of times on these forums, they're like, oh, is this a good assignment? Is this a good amount of money? No one can really tell you if it's a good amount of money if you don't know what you need. You need to know how much money you need monthly at home, how much money you're going to need away on your travel assignment. Combine those totals, and then you need to know how much you're going to be making net from your travel assignment. And if you have more bills than you're making money, then that is not a good assignment for you. So that was a mistake that I made. Luckily for me, my bills have been the same since I started travel nursing, but my income has increased, so I was able to keep it afloat. But I know some nurses who run into a lot of issues because they don't know their budget and they're just making these travel nurse money, but they're living check to check because they haven't really planned financially on going on these assignments. My number 3 rookie travel nurse mistake is, if possible, have some initial money. I have heard horror stories. This didn't happen to me personally. You know what? I do have a horror story, but I'll tell you that after I get my point across. I know people who come just on a wing up in a prayer to do travel assignments. That's okay if that's what you have to do. But I would say to have a little cushion money because, girl, you can get out there and they can cancel the contract and you have to get back home. You can get out there and there's a delay. You need housing accommodations. You need to have a rental car. You need public transportation. You have to put up money first prior to you getting your first check. So just have your little man money in case things don't go as planned. So that is a mistake. And let me tell you my little horror story. Child, so this was after I had been a nurse, travel nurse for a while. And thank God is so good because I had already started budgeting and just having a little bit more financial literacy. But girl, I was doing everything I needed to do. I was coming on time. I was doing my timesheets. Let me tell you why. One Friday, I checked my account and my money was not there. My money had not been direct deposited. Let me tell you, when I say I was livid, could not even describe how upset I was. And when I tell you I showed my natural behind, I showed it. And there was no compensation from this company. There was no remorsefulness. Just like, oh, I don't know what happened. Girl, let me tell you, I would spray on people, but I'm not going to do that because, honey, I don't want to get sued. I need all my coins. But it was a horrible experience, and I never worked for them again, and I probably never will work for them again. But imagine if I was just starting out. Imagine if that was at the beginning of my assignment. That can happen. What are you going to do if you don't have any cushion money? So make sure you have some type of little income. And if you don't, I understand too, because sometimes people do this just to make money. But just be mindful. That is a mistake that can be made that can be leave you in like dire straits. And nobody wants to be clear across the country and can't function or have anywhere, some place to sleep. I know somebody that happened to literally a person I met on a travel nurse assignment, and she was like sleeping in her car. So you don't want to be that type of nurse. No tea, no shade. Okay, rookie travel nurse mistake number 4 is remember that these agencies work for you. My mistake was like I was so timid, like, oh, this is a staff job. Like, I don't want to ask for too much. Listen, you need to be reasonable, but you also need to be assertive. This is your life. You become basically a contractor. You have to negotiate your terms. If there are days that you need off, if there is license renewal, certificate renewals, ACL, BLS, please make sure that you negotiate your contract to spell out as such and make sure that it is in the contract. Make sure all the money is correct because these agencies can get really, really shady, especially when it's not written in your contract. And I have had experiences where hospitals say, oh no, we need you to work these days, but it is spelled out in my contract, and honey, it's nothing they can do, period. They must honor that because that is what is in my contract and that is what I'll be doing. Okay. And also when it comes to overtime, if you don't have that spelled out in your contract, they may not pay you. So they may not pay you overtime. You may get regular flat rate. You need to make sure that all those things are spelled out in your contract so that way everything lines up and you don't have any problems in the long run. Okay, and my last rookie travel nurse mistake would be don't be afraid to turn down a contract. I used to be so timid and so afraid, like, oh my gosh, if I turn this contract, they're not going to. Listen, these people want to make money. When they see you and when they see you signing up to become a travel nurse, and I'm talking about the agencies, they see cash cows, okay? They get paid a lot of money for you to go where you're going to go, be good and effective at your job, and complete a contract. They get paid big money. So don't be afraid to turn down a contract that does not benefit you in the right way. And I'm not saying that be reasonable, people. This is a business. But if you need dates off, they can't give you dates off. If you need for them to pay you a certain amount of money that's reasonable, because I have a certain amount of money even to this day. If I say, you know what, let me go ahead and get back in this travel nurse game, I have a certain amount of money that I'm not leaving my house for. Period, point blank. I have a certain amount. If I'm not making such and such, I ain't leaving my house. It's not worth the money. And you need to be that way too. Don't let these people force you or push you into a contract that you don't want, because you are going to be there 13 weeks and it could be 13 weeks of living hell. So make sure that you are not afraid to turn down a contract. Another contract will come. Trust me, nursing has a shortage, and this shortage is for experienced nurses. If you're considering being a travel nurse, that means you have experience. That means you are a commodity. So treat yourself as such. Now, with that being said, drop any comments, questions below. I will answer them. I love interacting with you guys. It makes it all worth my while to do these videos. And most importantly, I want you to know that I love you, but God, He loves you so much more. God bless you.